إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أرسل الرسل مبشرين ومنذرين لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ رسالة ربه وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك أما بعد أيها الإخوة والأخوات في الله تعالى فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل وخير الهدي هدي النبي محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين ثم أما بعد Praise be to Allah, the merciful and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to protect all of us, grant us al-Jannah, al-Firdaus al-A'la, gather us with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and forgive our parents, our teachers, our mashayikh, Make us of those who listen to the word of wisdom, Quran and Sunnah, apply it, practice it, perform it in the best manners. We ask Him Almighty to shower those who passed, shower their grave with His rahmah, and forgive them. And we ask Him Almighty to give shifa, cure, speedy recovery to whoever needs. Shifa, Ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, last week we spoke about actions leads you to Al-Jannah. And we learned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create you to have hardship in this life or to have many obstacles or burden on your shoulders. طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى. Rather, He commanded us with simple tasks. If we just practice them, Al-Jannah will be yours. And still, we didn't get it, we don't practice it. One of them, You do not associate with Allah any. Ash-shirk billah. If you don't have shirk, you are safe. The second, You believe in Allah, His Prophet. You perform prayer and fasting. You will be of those entering Al-Jannah. Third, you build a masjid, or you help in building a masjid. You will enter Al-Jannah. You pray Fajr and Asr Al-Bardain. The Prophet ﷺ said, if you do that, you will enter Al-Jannah. You keep going to the masjid and going back and coming back. Just taking a trip to the masjid, round trip, you will be safe and enter Al-Jannah. Also, the Prophet ﷺ said, number six, that if you safeguard your tongue, you safeguard your private part, you will have big chance to enter Al-Jannah. If you pray 12 rak'ah a day, and they are easy, 12 rak'ah, you will enter Al-Jannah. 2 rak'ah before subh, 4 before dhuhr, 2 after dhuhr, and 2 after Maghrib, and 2 after Isha, 12 rak'ah, you will enter Al-Jannah. To seek knowledge and to spend effort and money to gain knowledge, you travel, you come to the masjid to attend lectures with the intention that seeking knowledge, learning, becoming better person, that is your way to Al-Jannah. Today, inshallah, we will mention many more. If you just say, Raditu billahi rabba, wa bil islami deena, wa bi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nabiyan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, wajabat lahu al-jannah. This is not my saying or my ijtihad. No. That's clear words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To see how much you're missing, my brother, just saying, Raditu billahi rabba, I'm satisfied that Allah Almighty is my Lord, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is my Prophet, and Islam is my religion, Al-Jannah will be yours. Subhanallah. And those that you believe in and you always make dua that Allah to keep you on that track, they will come in your grave and protect you from the grave punishment. Of course, when you say Raditu billahi rabba, like I'm pleased with Allah, pleased with Him as my Lord, that means you should obey. You don't say you're pleased with Allah and you do not pray, and you do not fast, and you do not perform Hajj or Umrah. You rejected that. That's not satisfying. That's not pleasing. So you are doing the opposite of accepting, submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Lord. Also, when you say that I'm pleased, satisfied with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as my teacher, as my prophet, what's that mean? You look what he was doing. You follow his footstep. That's real and actual pleasing or actual satisfaction. Next, if you just say Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdi, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qala Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdi, ghurisat lahu nakhla fil jannah." Whoever says Subhanallah al-Azim, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وبحمده, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will plant for him a date palm tree. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will plant it for you to enjoy it in the hereafter. That means you will enter Al-Jannah. And I want you to remember, the trees in Al-Jannah, not like the tree we have. Very small tree. You can hardly sit under the shadow of them. The tree in Al-Jannah, you walk many years to reach the end of its shadow. Imagine, just Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdi. One time, you get a palm tree, date palm tree. You make them 100, you make them 10, you get 10 palm tree. Imagine, the land that you will own, you will enjoy in Al-Jannah. How many acres? You will own when you meet with your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next, if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you Al-Jannah, to grant you Al-Jannah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سأل الله الجنة ثلاث مرات قالت الجنة اللهم أدخله الجنة. If you ask Allah three times, oh please Allah, let me enter Al-Jannah. Oh please Allah, let me enter Al-Jannah. How easy is this? Three times, just asking Him. You know what? Al-Jannah itself, that Allah created it, it will come forward and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you Al-Jannah. Allah bring him to Al-Jannah. Just asking Allah three times to make you of those Ahlul Jannah. Al-Jannah will make the dua for you and ask Allah for you to be one of its people. And same thing with hellfire. If you ask Allah three times to protect you from hellfire, just ask. An-Nar itself, hellfire, will come forward and will say, Allah, please, protect him from me. Which means, if Allah protect you from hellfire, means that you will enter Al-Jannah. Dear brothers and sisters, sounds like easy, but what you need to do is believe in that with your heart. Don't just speak it out with your tongue. You just believe it. Once you believe it, Allah will grant it. Next, if you perform Umrah and you follow it with another Umrah, the sins in between will be expiated, diminished, cleared, forgiven. From one Umrah to another. But if you perform Hajj, the reward for Hajj is Al-Jannah. Imagine, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the door of Hajj again and to make us of those who perform Hajj once again for many years to come. Ameen. So continuous practicing, performing Umrah, your sins will be forgiven. But performing one Hajj, Al-Jannah is due for you. Dear brothers and sisters, saying the truth, it's a door for you to Al-Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Like saying the truth will lead you to goodness, al-birr. Al-birr is the name of all goodness. So as-sidq will lead you to al-birr. And those goodness that you practice will lead you to al-jannah. And you know what? The same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you continue saying the truth, you become sadiq. And people will know about you that you are sadiq. Not only on the face of the earth. You will be enrolled up there in the seventh heaven. The angels will enroll you in the record of people that they always say the truth. And of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that. Same thing with kadhib. If you lie, and as I always say, there is no small lie and big lie, white lie or black lie. There is no such a thing. All of them, even if you consider small, big, white, brown, red, black, you describe it as a lie. Same thing. Lying will lead you to hellfire. Because lying will lead you to no good. And you will be enrolled up there in the seventh heaven that you are a liar. Not only people on the face of the earth will consider you as a liar, but the angels will know about you. You are nothing but a liar. Next, the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ يَتَوَضَّ فَيُحْسِنِ الْوُضُوءِ وَيُصَلِّي رَكْعَتَيْنِ يُقْبِلْ بِقَلْبِهِ وَوَجْهِهِ عَلَيْهِمَا إِلَّا وَجَبَتْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever make wudu, good wudu, and pray two rak'ah, not farida, not subh, not sunnat al-dhuhr, no, two rak'ah after wudu, which Hadrat Bilal used to do them and practice them. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam heard his flip-flop in Al-Jannah, he said, what do you do? He said, I pray two rak'ah after wudu. Dear brothers and sisters, you make wudu with excellence. And you pray two rak'ah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your heart. Not with your organ, with your heart. Believing in it that Allah will forgive you. And you focus on those rak'ah khushu'. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Jannah will be due to you. Like Allah will give you Al-Jannah. Imagine. Simple tasks. We all neglect. And if we are wise and smart, each and every one of us will have acres of land in Al-Jannah. We'll have many houses in Al-Jannah, many ghuraf in Al-Jannah. He will be fame in Al-Jannah. The angels will know him by the trustworthy, the one that never lied. As I said, those are easy tasks. We neglect most of them. We don't practice it, although they won't take effort and time. We try to do them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala become pleased with us. We ask Him Almighty to forgive all of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده وأصلي وأسلم على من لا نبي بعده. Praise be to Allah the Merciful and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One last task, easy one, and it's very easy to perform. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ayyuha an-nas, afshu salam, spread salam. Say assalamu alaikum to one another. Just saying it. How long that will take? Do not abbreviate it. Now people, they abbreviate it, as I said before. They write to you AA. I don't know what AA stand for. I know AA stand for American Airline. It's not assalamu alaikum. Only few letters. You write them. Afshu, spread salam to whoever, whether you know him or not. Feed people, poor, rich. Feeding people is not only for poor. You invite even rich people. And those rich people and poor people, they have to accept the invitation, not rejecting it. Feed people. وَأَطْعِمُوا الطَّعَامِ وَصَلُّوا. Pray while people are sleeping. Salatul Layl. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, end of the hadith, he said, تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامِ. You will enter al-jannah with peace and ease. Imagine. Dear brothers and sisters, those two khutbah that we mentioned, those tasks, the easy tasks, which we will make you of those of Ahlul Jannah. What I want from you is just pick from 3 to 5. We mentioned 16. Just pick 3 to 5 and continue to practice them until it becomes your habit. Practice them with your heart. And inshallah, we will meet, if we practice that, we will meet in Al-Jannah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those Ahlul Jannah. With the prophets, with the shuhada, with the righteous people. We ask Him Almighty to forgive our parents, our teacher, our mashayikh. We ask Him Almighty to give shifa to whoever needs shifa. We ask Him to forgive all of us. We ask Him to bless all of us, our family, our children, our trades, our jobs. We ask Him Almighty to protect us from the pandemic, from whichever trial that we going through. We ask Him Almighty to open the door of Hajj for all of us to perform Hajj. We ask Him to have mercy with those who passed and forgive them and reward them and replace their sins to hasanat. We ask Him Almighty to make us as happy as we can be in this life and in the grave, in the hereafter. Ameen. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
الله أكبر.